Witam ponownie, z tej strony Polyglot, and in this video we'll be discussing the present forms of ch verbs. This applies to verbs that end in a vowel followed by ch that don't sort into any of the other verb types, and they're usually monosyllabic. The pattern for this verb type is the stem vowel followed by je, je, and jo. One of the main examples are verbs ending in uć, such as czuć, to feel, which conjugates czuję, czuję, and czują. Similarly, pluć, to spit, conjugates pluje, pluje, plują. Now, I said each and ich would make a comeback, so here it is. This verb type also applies to monosyllabic ich, ich verbs that are simple. Now, simplicity is arbitrary, but verbs like mścić or chrzcić don't belong here, is what I'm basically saying, so those are just normal ich verbs. Verbs like pić, to drink, or żyć, to live, do, however. Pić is conjugated pije, pije, piją, and żyć is conjugated żyje, żyje, żyją, as opposed to pie or że. This also applies to derivations, which at times can be difficult to spot. Once I conjugated the verb użyć to use as użę, failing to notice that the verb is in fact żyć prefixed with u, and thus conjugates użyję, I will use. Ać, or rather jać, also makes one last appearance here, except its stem vowel is actually e. This is the first stem change of the series. Due to historical development, some vowel changes occurred in some cases where a word became monosyllabic and was followed by certain consonants, and in this case, e turned into a. So, we have words like grzać, to warm, which conjugates as grzeje, grzeje, grzeją. Other words like this are lać, to pour, siać, to sew, śmiać się, to laugh, and wiać, to blow, like the wind. And that concludes ch verbs. That got a little linguistic, I do apologize, but hey, it's a crash course. As long as you're able to recognize the various verb forms, all should be alright. The next part will be covering ch verbs, which aren't actually anything new from what you've learned so far, so I'll see you then.